some questions, not really to have you answer out loud, but more to think about in your mind what those answers might be. We are going to tell a story of creation. Our story begins a long time ago, long before school started, long before third years were first years, indeed long before anyone in this room was born. Our story starts before humans, or animals, or plants, or any life lived on Earth. It starts before the Earth was made, before time, and before space. Our story is the story of the universe, and it is the story of us. It begins when there was nothing. Can you imagine everything being nothing? How huge is nothing? How dark is nothing? How cold is nothing? How boring is nothing? Now, out of this nothing, light was created. So out of nothing, light was created. Well, now we are getting somewhere. This is better than nothing. But how did we get here? How did we get something out of nothing? That, for us humans, is one of the greatest mysteries. What scientists call a singularity. From this one singular point came everything we know. Scientists imagine this single concentrated point, smaller than the point of a pin, to be infinitely hot and infinitely dense. It was so dense because it contained everything that is now part of the universe. It was so hot that the matter we see around us, earth, rocks, iron, gold, water, all existed as gases, all in this one tiny point. And then, the Big Bang.
Oh.
But scientists say there is no sound in space. Perhaps we should call it the Great Flaring Forth. In less than a second, this intense point exploded into a great flare with everything rushing away from everything else, expanding. Imagine that. And the universe has never stopped expanding. It is expanding now, at this moment. Let's pause our story for a moment to consider the way we see the universe moving. It moves a lot like our own lungs, and we take a breath in and then out. Slowly take a breath into your body. Feel your lungs expand and breathe out slowly. Feel your lungs contract. In, out. Expansion, contraction. These are the primal movements of the universe from which everything came into existence. We've just seen the expansion with the great flaring forth. Now a new and powerful force begins to work in the universe, gravity. As the great flare expanded, gravity began to work by contraction, pulling matter together into clumps. Great clouds of the universe's very first elements, hydrogen and helium gases, were pulled together. These were galaxies. Gravity then squeezed some of the hydrogen and helium even more tightly together. More contraction, and stars. Stars were born. Beautiful. And stars, my friends, are, well, the stars of our story. Stars continually burn the first two elements that the universe created, hydrogen and helium. This is what our own sun is doing right now. As stars burn, they expand larger and larger, until the force of gravity causes them to contract, collapsing in on themselves. When they contract, they burn even hotter and then expand even more. Stars repeat this process again and again, expansion and contraction. It is as if the universe itself is breathing long, slow breaths through the stars. Until at last, stars explode with one final expansion, throwing out clouds of stardust. This is called a supernova.
Whoa.
Scientists tell us that this dust from a supernova contains all the elements that form everything we can see. Some of this stardust forms into new stars. Some of this stardust becomes planets, including the rocks of our own Earth. Some of this dust is oxygen, carbon, nitrogen, and the other essential elements that make up our friends in this room. Luna, Jonas, Paxton, Bella. The elements generated from stars form all things, including rocks, leaves, water, giant sequoia redwood trees, rainbows, strawberries, elephants, bees, diamonds, dragonflies, honey, ferns, whales, snowflakes, moths, triceratops, raindrops, and fire. Stars are the creation centers of our universe, continually remaking, renewing, and recycling everything in it. Scientists estimate that there are as many stars in the universe as there are grains of sand on all the beaches of our planet Earth. One of these stars, like one grain of sand among thousands and billions of grains of sand, is our sun. And much smaller, much, much smaller than our sun, 1 millionth part of this grain is our Earth, a tiny speck in the vast darkness. Now, with the creation of these things, the universe is becoming more and more complex and more interesting. Every part of the universe that we know was given a set of rules to follow. Some of the particles that came from stars follow the law of attraction. Some of the particles repel each other. Because of this, particles combined and formed clusters, becoming different things. Stars, asteroids, moons, and planets. In a very special place in our galaxy, the Milky Way galaxy. Particles of stardust combined to form a dense swirl. The force of gravity contracted. That swirl is what would become our own solar system.
Please stop putting your hands up.
And most of that dust became a new star. Our own sun. Other particles of dust slowly formed into planets, including our own Earth. And as the elements combined into matter, all of the matter was allowed to take one of three forms, a gas, a liquid, or a solid. Everything in the universe that we know of is either a gas, a liquid, or a solid. And which of these three forms the elements assume depends on how hot or cold it is. Our sun, that beautiful bright star, took the form of a gas. In fact, our own Earth, for the first 100 million years of its life, also took the form of a ball of fiery gas. As our Earth cooled, it formed a solid crust around the outer part of its sphere. This allowed our planet to settle and cool. However, the Earth's core was still so hot that the rocks there took the form of a liquid. For the next 400 million years, Earth was bombarded by asteroids, huge rocks hurtling through space. How could our planet become the place we know it is today with all that chaos? Well, if you were being pelted by rocks, wouldn't you want an older sibling to step in and help you out? We think of Jupiter as our big sister. Once Jupiter was created, the force of gravity from this huge planet pulled in asteroids, so that Jupiter now takes the blows from objects that would otherwise smash into Earth. Thank you, Jupiter.
Thank you, Jupiter.
And still, our planet would not calm down. Another law that the atoms of the universe follow says, if you are hot, you expand and rise up. If you are cold, you contract and fall. Well, that liquid rock core of our Earth had to rise up during those 400 million years all over the surface of the Earth. The crust was broken apart by the force of volcanoes.
Try and stay right on your seat. Right on your seat, because Alana's going to give a message about what's going to happen here.
Yeah. So I'm going to pour some liquid into our volcano here, and you need to see it erupt. So it's actually a red liquid. So if you want to go up on your knees, if you're in the back, you may. If you're in the back.
I still get in our back.
Excuse me. You can stand up.
Whoa.
It's a lot. It's magic.
So cool.
Finally, it was as if the great Mother Sun covered our young Earth with a blanket so that it would be at peace. Go ahead and sit on your bottoms. Thank you. And peace did come. Clouds of dust and smoke from the volcanoes covered the Earth from the sun for many years, and the Earth cooled and settled. Water from the clouds fell on the Earth and filled the craters and basins on its crust, forming streams, rivers, lakes, and oceans around the rocky land. At this point in our story, our planet has emerged from its turbulent childhood and showing itself as a nurturing young adult with the capacity to become our Mother Earth. You can see in our journey of the universe, from the great flaring forth to the formation of the Earth, how things are becoming more complex and more interesting. When we continue our story in a couple of weeks, we will witness the most interesting complexity yet to be seen in the universe. Life. So that's the end of my presentation on the story of the universe. Thank you